In this section, we'll talk about Minikube, kubectl, and how you can set them up so that you can start working with a real Kubernetes cluster locally. Well, as we discussed in the previous section, a typical production Kubernetes setup consists of three Kubernetes control plane nodes for high availability and many Kubernetes workers where you run your applications. As you already know, control plane nodes and workers have their own responsibilities. Typically, you would have separate physical or virtual machines for each type of node. Now, if you want to test something quickly on your laptop, such as deploying your application or new components, setting up a full-fledged Kubernetes cluster can be difficult, or maybe even impossible if you don't have a lot of resources, like memory or CPU. Minikube was created exactly for this use case, for testing purposes. Minikube is usually a single node cluster that combines control plane and worker node functionality. If you need to test something that requires a multi-node cluster, such as how your application handles disruptions, you can use Minikube for that as well. It's quite flexible. Typically, we don't run applications on master nodes. Internally, Kubernetes uses taints and tolerations to repel pods from control plane nodes. However, with a single node cluster, these constraints are removed. To run Minikube for a long time, we used to rely on external hypervisors that needed to be installed on your workstation. For example, we would install VirtualBox and Minikube would spin up a virtual machine for one node cluster. Recently, Minikube added native support for Docker. Now you can use Docker to create a container instead of a virtual machine for the Kubernetes cluster and run other Docker containers inside that cluster. You can use Docker driver for Minikube on Windows, Linux, and Mac. Now, to summarize, Minikube is one node Kubernetes cluster that will run inside a Docker container in our case, or a virtual machine, and you can use it for testing purposes on your laptop. Now, you need a way to interact with your local Kubernetes cluster on your laptop or PC. That's where kubectl comes into the picture. When you have a local Kubernetes cluster, you need a tool to interact with it. For example, you might need to create pods, services, config maps, or secrets. The easiest way to do this locally is by using kubectl. In production, we use GitOps principles and tools like argcd or fluxcd. If you remember from the previous section, all interactions with Kubernetes are done via API server. To do anything with your local cluster, the API server will be your entry point. To configure or manage anything in Kubernetes, you need to talk to API server first. You can interact with API server through different clients. This includes UI like open source Kubernetes dashboard, sending raw REST requests, or using CLI known as kubectl. Kubectl, one of the most powerful of these clients. With kubectl, you can do almost anything in Kubernetes. During this tutorial, we'll primarily use kubectl client to interact with Kubernetes. Whenever you send a request using kubectl to the control plane via API server, such as creating a pod or exposing it using a service, Kubernetes workers will make it happen. Worker nodes are responsible for executing most of the commands you send to Kubernetes, such as creating pods, destroying pods, or creating services, etc. So this is Minikube setup, and this is how kubectl is used to interact with a cluster. And it is also important to note is that kubectl is not only for the local Minikube cluster. If you have a cloud cluster, for example, EKS cluster in AWS, you can still interact with it using kubectl, and we frequently do. Kubectl is a tool to interact with any type of cluster, on premises, in the cloud, or even hybrid. So now we know what a Minikube cluster is and what kubectl is. It's time to install both and see them in practice. I use Mac, so I'll quickly show you how to install all these components on Mac, and I'll attach instructions on how to install those tools on Windows and Linux as well. Alright, since we'll use Docker as a Minikube driver, we need to install it first. It is also super easy. Just download distribution for your operating system. In my case, I use Mac with Apple Silicon and double click to start installation. I'll also attach all the links in the description for Windows, Linux, as well as Mac. Next, we need to start Docker. Before moving to the next step, make sure it's running. Now, I'll use Brew, which is a package manager for Mac. First of all, we need to refresh all repositories to get the latest versions. Then, I'll install Minikube with Brew. Minikube has a kubectl as a dependency, so we just need to install Minikube and we are ready. The same applies to Windows. When you download and install Minikube, you get kubectl as well. In my case, Kubernetes CLI is a bundle that includes kubectl CLI. To verify installation, let's run kubectl --help. If you get an error, it means it's not installed. Otherwise, you will get a bunch of subcommands that we can run, and I'll cover most of them in the following part. For now, we just need to make sure it is installed. Next, let's verify that Minikube CLI is installed as well. So let's run minikube --help. You'll see commands like start, status, delete, and others that you can use to manage your local Kubernetes cluster. We'll also cover many of them in the following section. It's also helpful to run kubectl version. This will give you the client version and also try to get the Kubernetes version. Since we haven't started Minikube yet, it will give you an error. Alright, time to start Minikube. Again, usually we run a single node cluster, so --node=1 is totally optional, since it's the default. Just keep in mind that if you need a multi-node cluster, just start Minikube with two or more nodes. Also, we'll use Docker as a driver. You can use VirtualBox or any other supported hypervisor if you want. There is little difference. Minikube will download Docker image and start Minikube inside the Docker container. You can run Minikube status to make sure all components are running. And if you check running containers, you'll see that Kate's Minikube Docker container is running as well. Finally, if you run kubectl version again, you'll see both client and server versions. Don't worry if they don't match, they have backward compatibility. So far, we have set up local environment, and in the following part, we'll start deploying applications to Kubernetes and exposing them to outside clients. We'll also learn the most common kubectl commands that you can use, including for debugging, which is very important.